today. I'm coming to you because I want to say this. What happens to you when, you know, you've got your plan, you're feeling zingy through the day because fruit and greens for the zing, you know? Zzz. That is how I feel best when my engine is running on fruit and greens and plenty of water during the day. Shh. Nothing can stop me, you know? What happens to people when you're living like that? You're doing it and you are doing it. You know, you are on fire, and then, I mean, you have the mental clarity of 10 women or men. You have the strength of everything you need is at your fingertips. And then the next thing you know, what happens? First of all, what things are we focusing on during the day? Because, yet again, what you focus on grows. Let's just say, for example, you're a person trying to do low-fat, raw vegan. That's your target, okay? That's your middle. It's right in the middle. You see that little bitty dot? That's your target. So, let's just say you're a woman, and PMS has some emotions that go around it. It's a lot of times makes women want chocolate. Okay, and you're trying to get off the chocolate. Well, let me ask you this. If you, you're thinking about chocolate, you're talking about chocolate, mama, oh, if I just had some chocolate, you know what kind of chocolate I like? Remember when we were at Gatlinburg and we got that fudge and it had those marshmallows inside and it had the little nuts, you know, and they had that kind of crispy sort of salty candy coating on the outside of them, and then it was like the white chocolate swirled in, and when you bit in you could almost like feel the marshmallow. Just the more you focus on that, the more your desire for it grows. So what is it you're looking at all through the day? You know, are you going to be looking at pictures of chocolate? Are you going to be, if you're trying to be a raw vegan, low fat, are you going to look at, I don't know, nut pate and recipes of all these abombo combos that don't keep you feeling zingy? Are you going to look at, I don't know, all this cooked vegan food? Are you going to look at maybe like the mock hamburger pie or whatever it is? When you focus on that, if that is not your goal, and I'm not saying that's not a good place for some people to be, I'm just saying if that's not your goal, if your goal is true 80-10-10, low-fat, raw vegan, low-fat, high-carb vegan, more raw every day, then what you focus on is going to grow. So I'm just saying we might want to be careful of what we focus on, right? If you're a person trying to get off of alcohol, guess what? Quit listening to country music, because they are tipping it on back in every song, you know? Quit going out to the bars to hang out with your friends that last week you were just so smashed you couldn't even drive home, though you did. Quit going to these places and looking and doing these things that make the very thing you're wanting to stop doing grow. That makes no sense to me. If you're a person who wants to stop watching pornography, though you keep looking at it a little bit, do you think that helps you because you're weaning off? Or do you think that feeds your desire for that a little bit more? Another thing, emotional eating. Okay, some people don't think this is a real thing. I happen to think it is. I think it is a real thing because one of the primary ways that we as humans handle painful emotions is to numb them with alcohol, with drugs, with, you might be doing some of this self-cutting stuff. You might be pulling your hair out. You may be just slamming your head into the wall. You may be numbing yourself with food, and it can be raw food. Are you numbing yourself, or are you eating to live? It's effective to numb yourself like that because your body only has so much vital force at any given time, and this is how your nerve system works. Okay, so our bodies only have so much of this, And digestion is the biggest process your body does every day. It takes more vital force than anything else. When you cram in a whole jar of nut butter and you follow it with some chia crackers and then you had a 25 banana smoothie, do you not think you're going to numb your emotional state because your vital force is working on that abombo combo and fat-laden meal plus another meal, and then you're going to have to basically lay down. It's like after you eat a giant Thanksgiving dinner. So it's very effective, you know. It's the same effectiveness as with alcohol. Your body is zoned in on trying to what the heck to do with that toxic poison, right? Digesting a heavy load or emotional stress takes a lot of energy, you know? So here's the thing. What are you going to let your body focus on? Let's just say somebody's had a death, or have you ever seen somebody that had somebody real close to them die, and or they're at a funeral, for example, and some people would just like not eat for days, and some people would just eat their stuff into a numb state. It just depends on how people deal with something or don't deal with it, you know. But the thing is, as we lighten our digestive loads with the 80-10-10 low-fat raw vegan style diet and lifestyle every day, your body's not having to work that hard, you know? So you're going to start noticing and being more aware of your emotional sides. You will really notice this if you won't go on like a juice fast or water fast, because there's nowhere to hide. You know what I'm saying? You know, and even if we're committed to like low-fat raw vegan or raw vegan, and we may just go overboard on the combos. We may go overboard. We don't need 5,000 calories if we're a normal person. You know what I'm saying? We may go overboard on the fat or the abombo combos, or just go to those places that don't bring you the vitality that you thrive on, you know? This is why I feel like mono meals are great for training yourself on this, because it enables you to realize, like, let's just say I'm having a mono meal of mangoes, and I would have probably a greens with that because I always do. Mono meals and lettuce. Let's just say I'm having that. Let's just say I'm having this right here. It's what I have for breakfast. Oh, minus that lemon. It's just sitting there, but I'm fixing to have the rest of that. Let's just say you were having that. I'm not going to be searching like on and on for flavors and different varieties and all this. I'm going to just be full when I'm full on mangoes. Do you know what I mean? And even if I overeat them, it's not going to take the body nearly the digestive force to digest that one item, you know? So it can be helpful. It can be helpful in retraining you to get back to the simplicity, to enjoy. You know, somebody was just asking me about salt, and I was just telling them, you know, it really does. It sort of embalms the body, you know? And two, it keeps you from tasting the natural flavors in food. It keeps your taste buds numb, you know, to where you can't enjoy the natural flavors of just a mono meal. We got to get off the salt. Or this is what I found worked for me in the past, so that I can really enjoy fresh, raw, ripe, whole fruits and vegetables for the win, you know? But the comfort food zone, you know, we've got to, before we numb ourselves, we have got to remember where we're wanting to go. Stop in your tracks. Have a few things that, like, let's just say a comfort food for me, or to keep me from doing something crazy like that, would be my tomato soup. That's still raw, but it's warm out of the Vitamix. I would put it in a mug. I would be sipping on that while I go to my vision board and remember who I am. And remember what I want to be. And remember to be emotionally in the moment. And to be emotionally stable is to deal with your emotions, right? Not just cram them back down. Or, you know, maybe it's banana ice cream and celery. Or maybe it's a huge smoothie before you, you know, just stop in that moment. Take time to care about you enough to stop in that moment. Soon you'll be able to used to this lifestyle and used to not numbing down your emotions, because really, do we want to numb them down or do we want to deal with them? And enjoy each emotional state for that matter, because it is your life, you know? I know a lot of people, and every day after work they get drunk. I don't mean they're just having a drink or two. Every day they get drunk. It is like they live to do that. They live to not live their life. They live to be zoned out. What's the point in you if you're going to do that, you know? Make sure you're carbed up. Make sure you're getting your carb calories from fruit every day. Fruit and greens through the day. A little bit of chia seeds for stability. On through the day. Lots of water. Plenty of rest. De-stress. Body movement. You know, positive thinking and positive energy for a positive life, right? We just need tools in our toolbox, that's all. I'll stand with you. With you walking all of this when I sail away.